Hey everyone, it's EIzen the Broniac here. I still feel bad that I can't do Corpse Party, but maybe there's another game I should try. I don't know. Let's check the old NES simulator and see if there's anything good on. God damn it. Yep, I guess it's back to this. Ladies and gentlemen, to replace Corpse Party, we're tackling a game apparently was so scary, it was heavily censored in Japan, and if memory serves, originally meant for Japan, yet never really got sold in Japan. So with that, let's tackle a game that Deceased Crab told us not to play, but I'm gonna be playing it anyway. Monster Party.
Dum-dum-dum-dum, Mark was just walking home from a ball game. He suddenly looked up and saw a bright star in the sky. While he stared at it...
End of... that... sentence, I don't know why.
The star got bigger and bigger. The beauty of the star made his eyes moist.
Were pretty much moist to begin with, but whatever.
So he didn't even notice that the star fell and landed right in front of him. Also, I don't know why I sound like some high-class gentleman. But anyway, it turns out that it wasn't really a star, but a monster instead. So it was then that Mark quickly asked him,
"Who are you?"
"I'm Bert."
"Where's Bert?" Whatever.
"What's up?"
Oh, you can't go for a "What's up, my dog?" Or "What up? Where you at?" Or what? I'm gonna stop doing it now.
"I'm looking for help. You see, evil monsters are out of control in my world. Come and help me."
"I'm afraid to fight the evil monsters."
Oh, come on, can't you just sound like... it's too terrifying, I'm not really sure what happens.
"I'm too afraid to fight them evil monsters."
"Don't worry. With your weapon, you'll be able to destroy them very easily."
And you needed an extra space just for the period and quotation. See, Bandai, this is why I'm disappointed in you. Punctuation.
"But this isn't a weapon, it's a bat!"
"Bat, batter, anything is okay. Anyhow, let's go. I could even use you as a weapon if need be."
Bert then grabbed Mark's hand and flew away, off to Never Never Land!
Seriously, when you look at that pose, doesn't it make you think Peter Pan? "What's your name?"
"Mark."
"Mark. My planet... I thought you said it was a world. Anyway.
My insert name here is dangerous. So, we must act together.
How?
Like this! The evil grabby touch!" They then fuse together. And with that, this is how Mark's seizure began!
But yeah, anyway, let's get to the actual game. Basically, you use the B to hit or attack, and then A to jump. And although you can use your bat to shoot enemies, aim again at me, buddy. Thank you. You can reflect them back at your enemy, and it should instantly kill your enemies with one hit. Also, what the hell is up with that pose? That just makes no sense. It's pretty self-explanatory. Hard rooms increase your health, and there are doors you can enter. Pretty necessary if you want to complete the game.
Hello, baby!
Thank you, Audrey. Probably a bit closer. There we go. Now, you can fight this as how Bert proclaimed by fusing together, but I think for this boss, it's kind of easier if you're marked do so. Because you can do a decent amount of damage with your bat. If you're able to reflect the projectiles back to the enemy, it does much more damage. Pretty much instant kill for regular monsters, and just much better damage if you were using your bat. And seriously, how many hits are you gonna take before you die? Come on, just die already. Die already. Die already, please. I don't want to spend forever and a half in just this one level. Thank you. And question marks, they could be anything. In this case, just points. Also, what the hell? That pose is even more wrong. Just go ahead and hump the ground. You're truly Earth's greatest hero. Or this world's hero, anyway. Hey, come on. There. Just wanted to grab a heart. That's all I want. Just have a heart. Also, just gonna do that, just for the hell of it. And, come on. Die. More health for me. And this is an interesting thing. Take pills. Why is that? Transformation scene! And with that, you are now able to fly, and also you can't do the whole flying animation. And what is in this room? Nothing! So now we just exit the room. Also, one thing I should mention is that most of the enemies in this game drop the same items in the same exact location. So, with that said, if you know which enemies drop what, the only grinding you have to do is on the exact same enemies. So, easy way how to save some time there. But seriously, this world isn't really that bad. I mean, sure, it looks a bit awkward, but I'm sure it's a real fixer-upper. Also, here's the first boss.
Sorry, Christopher, but I'm already dead.
And like that, it just kills himself. Yeah, let's turn back into Mark at this point. What does this item hold? Health! So yeah, if you get health regularly, it restores, like I believe, 2 points of health. If you do a question mark health thing, I think it drops at least 4, if not 5 for that. Also, I love the animation Marks makes when he hits his head on the ceiling. But that is neither here or there. Would you stop trying to go after me? But yeah, let's just move onward here. And I can't. Would you just take the hit already? It's a cactuar. Doesn't really seem that threatening, but guess what? Now we enter true horror land! Dear me, it's frightening. But I'm actually quite surprised, the amount of censorship that, this game brought forth. Pills. Or just a question mark, and that is an ugly, ugly looking dog. Let's see if we can actually kill it this time around. Nothing! So I just killed it just to kill it. But you know, I think pills would be very helpful right now. You don't have any pills. Let's try respawning the dog and see if we can get anything from you. Yes! There are the pills we need! So with that said, let's just keep moving onward. I see weird eyes. I must kill it. Nothing.
Please don't pick on me. Oh, what's the matter, Pumpkinhead? You don't want to play?
Yeah, like I said, there are some enemies where it's easier to fight as Mark, but other times it might be easier if you're Bert for this. Like, it's kind of hard to launch projectiles at this type of boss. And I think all that gave us was a set of keys, so we'll take that. Keys are necessary if you're gonna unlock the door out of the level, so may as well do that for what it's worth. Also, am I able to hit him from down there? I am, so let's just do that. Also, that is not a stable ground, so we're gonna have to use that in order to get across. Ah! How dare he knock me down? How dare you knock me down? Ah! I'm sorry, I know there's no purpose in doing so, but I want to kill you! I want to kill you, dog. There. All for nothing. Also, that's pretty much a symbolism of spikes. There's really no need to do that. That door can lead to nowhere, so I'm pretty sure there's no need to do that one. All you need to do, once you have the key, is just head for the final door, and you're set. And that was just points. So, let's just keep moving on here. Kill that bulging eye that's walking on tentacles! Seriously, have you ever seen something that walks on tentacles? Let alone an eyeball? No, seriously, that's why I'm asking. I want to know if you're familiar with this. I'm not. Damn it. Oh well. We'll just ignore that. As you can see, that is the final door, so let's just move a bit over here. See what you drop. Nothing. So I'm glad to see we wasted our time here. And yet, you can head all the way to the final door, but only when you had the key can you end the level. So that is level 1. Hope you all enjoyed that. Your password is TinKitMP. Whatever. Round 2! The sewer level! Truly, this is a hellhole. That. And mouths that just appear from out of the walls! Truly, it is a dangerous place, and yeah. You don't even have to climb it, you can just jump all over it. Because, why not? What's in the store? Let's mix it up! And yeah, I get the feeling this boss, you can attack him on the ground, but it's probably easier if you just go for the face. Also, right I'm going, I think I might die before I kill this boss. So I'll have to be extra careful, I'm trying to say, but look what's happening. I'm seriously gonna get myself killed before I do any damage. And health up, so that's greatly appreciated. And, of course, I know that dropped nothing, but let's just, go back. In case you're wondering, of course I'm gonna do this repeatedly to grind for health. After all the amount I lost earlier, I think I deserve some health back. Now, seriously, get back here. Gotta beat some sense into you, buddy. Or me, for that matter. Look at all the hits I'm taking from my head. And it doesn't cost me any health. Know what I mean? Ow. took an unnecessary hit. Let's at least go for one more, and after that I'll say we'll have enough health to continue onward. Alright, moving onward. Hey, could you launch another one? Thank you. Now seriously, for some enemies, if you're able to reflect it back at them, I'd say that's more appropriate. And now we get Bert back on our side. Yes, we killed him with projectiles! With our deadly projectiles. And yes, we can shoot while we're downed. Which I think would be extremely helpful. Especially against certain enemies. It's a must. And yeah, do you see how much damage that frickin' thing takes? Let's go for our health up. Go for our health up. There we go. Carefully. Get through there. And actually, let's see. Can I, reflect it at you? Close enough. So now we got through there. Easily make our way through here. Nothing! Glad we trekked all that way for nothing. So moving onward. Sorry. Maybe that's what they meant by planking as a new move of the future. I don't know, folks. Why are you looking at me for answers? I clearly don't have any. And, could you... Thank you. See? Multiple shots, it took forever, yet one reflective hit brought him down. And how dare I take another hit? But at least now we're Bert again! Thanks to the power of... pill pushing! I don't even know! Don't you dare try anything on me, buddy. Also, I noticed, a doorway there. It's probably not gonna have anything, but I have to know. Pfft. Even take hits from there. Nothing! So let's just avoid that door. And head back this way, because I know we're gonna lose our pill power. Let's just refresh it. Good thing is, if you know where the pills are and are able to recover it, be sure you do so. Much needed. Alright, let's try here instead. Any health? Okay, you can go down now, buddy. Thank you. Look out, baby! It's the deadly shrimp! Here I come! And now, deadly onion rings! Oh dear. This... And I was still, Mark. Oh yeah. And I failed to make the jump there. And the screen didn't flash. For certain times! I think this is probably the only boss I know of that has, multiple forms, and why didn't I jump again? And again, I didn't jump! What's going on? Ah! Okay, seriously, I was doing fine before... There, thank you. It's not that difficult to do. Ah! Wait for it to come back. There we go. Can I get the item? This. Why am I not getting that item? Was it seriously for nothing? Thanks a bunch, game. Glad to know we did all that for nothing. definitely makes my trip worthwhile. Anyway, I'm going back here because, once again, I feel the need to take pills. I mean, after all, I am known for playing Binding of Isaac on hard mode as Cain, and he is definitely a pill pusher. But, yeah, seriously, folks, if you can, don't take pills. Don't do drugs. You'll save yourself a lot of time and effort if you just avoid it altogether. Pretty sure you'll live longer. Pretty sure you will. You can go down. Do you have anything of worth? Doesn't seem like it. Easily. Egg? I was gonna say, you can shoot something now. There. Nothing. Nothing! Absolutely nothing! But it dropped something this time. Gave me health! Alright, I'll take that. Ooh. Careful now. Not too concerned about not getting any pills from that because, well, it doesn't move, so what's my big concern? That, however, does give me pills. I'll just shoot you multiple times, so you can eventually die, and I believe that just gave me pills. There was nothing up there, so why did I bother going there? Probably because it felt like I didn't have much of a choice, and wow, I just barely dodged the acid there. But anyway, I think here is the real boss we have to face. Time to do some damage! And again, you can be, marked for this, but just look at how easily he fell. Yeah, now we finally have the key. So we can move onward with our journey? I don't know. But we're able to move onward. That much I know for certain. Drop down there. You. Thank you. Move onward here. Nothing. Boo. But if memory serves, we should be close to the end of this level. Oh. Oh, come on. One more. One more. One more. Come on. Will you just die already? There. Okay, there's the end of the pipe. We can put an end to the sewer level. Finally. And you dropped nothing, but it don't matter. We are done with the sewer level. Yay, we finally got the worst part out of the way. No, actually, I know about this game. Muskmultus is our next password screen. But trust me, that is nowhere near the worst level of the game. Trust me, we will come to that level at a later point. Which, speaking of a later point, we will get to round 3 next time. Because I know it's a bit early, but I really don't want to push this any further. And I realized if I am going to do the Afterbirth DLC for Binding of Isaac Rebirth, it's only going to be available on the 30th, and I got to find some way how to pad this out. So I'm definitely going to do the first two stages, or the first two videos of this game today, and then tomorrow you'll see the rest of the game, and then most likely on Halloween, that's when I'll upload the first parts of Afterbirth. But with that said, Hope you all enjoyed this video, and we shall see you on the next part. So until then, folks, take care, and goodbye.